So the story goes, and this is a sahih story. The story goes that when Ali bin Abi Talib was Amir al-Mu'mineen, and not only was he Ali bin Abi Talib at the time, he was also what? Amir al-Mu'mineen. His shield was stolen. His shield for war, for battle, was stolen. Please try to leave this story, and I'll try and stop and inject a few things that I feel are very important. But please, just a couple of minutes left, try to leave the story with me. So Ali bin Abi Talib, he's stolen, his shield is stolen. So he's walking in the marketplace and he sees a Jew selling it. He looks at the shield, he goes, man, this thing looks exactly like mine. So he picks up the shield, he's looking at it, then he finds markings that he knew. So Ali finds some markings on the shield, khalas, he's convinced beyond all doubt, this, not only is mine stolen, this is it, 100%. So he says to the Jew, he says, oh Jew, this is my shield that you're selling. And it was stolen from me. He didn't accuse him of stealing it. He said to him, but it was stolen from me. This is mine, it belongs to me. So the Jew says, no, this is my property and I'm selling it. So now we obviously have a very typical dilemma. It's mine, now it's not. So Ali bin Abi Talib, who at the time was Amir al-Mu'mineen, who really didn't have to do anything. He would have took the shield, tara'u kafla al-Jew al-Husiran, and now you're wrong. He could have very well done it, and no one was going to open his mouth with Ali bin Abi Talib. So Ali bin Abi Talib says, fine. Obviously, there's a situation here. We can sit down and argue about it all day long, or we can sort it out like civilized people. Today, we don't sort things out like civilized people anymore, do we, eh? That's my gap versus your gap, huh? It's my boys versus your boys now. So Ali bin Abi Talib goes to the court. He took the Jew to the court system and said to the judge, he says, I have a dispute with this man. He says, fine. They walk in, proper court system. He says, what's happening? Imagine Amir al-Mu'mineen, not only is the leader of the Muslims, but he's Ali bin Abi Talib, and he's standing in front of a Muslim judge that he assigned. Yani Ali is the one that assigned the guy. He says, this Jew has my shield, and my shield was stolen from me, and it's my shield. You know, I have to pause. Forgive me, I have to pause. Imagine this judge. This judge, forget that he's Amir al-Mu'mineen. Bro, that's Ali bin Abi Talib. That's, according to some valid opinions, the first Muslim ever. Ali bin Abi Talib. The first Muslim ever. Not only the first Muslim, he was raised in the house of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Not only that, the Prophet of Allah promised him Jannah countless times. Not only that, he's married to the daughter of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who will be the queen of the women of paradise. Not only that, he's the father of Al-Hasan wal-Husayn. Not only that, he's Amir al-Mu'mineen. Yani, does Ali really have to twist any of our arms and tell me, wallahi, this is mine? Habib, after, but it's yours. I don't care what the Jew has to say. And how many times have you heard a one-sided story, but because it came from your mate? Khalas, you already made a conclusion, eh? So the judge, talk about being in a sticky situation. He says, Ali, since you're the one making the accusation, he says, do you have any proof? Do you have any evidence? Do you have a witness? So Ali bin Abi Talib, he says, yes. And I want to ask you, by Allah, be honest with me. Does someone like Ali bin Abi Talib, does he need a witness? Be honest. Does he need a witness? He says, Ali, you're putting me in a sticky situation here, man. He says, do you have a witness? So Ali bin Abi Talib says, yes, I do. Just says, alhamdulillah. He says, who do you have? He says, my son Al-Hasan. Well, if that was you and I, get the Jew and everyone jump on him. And so look at what the Muslim judge says. He says, Ya Ali. He says, you know I can't take Al-Hasan as a witness. He's your son. What the hell? Now imagine you, Ali bin Abi Talib. Habib, forget the shield now. You little update now. It's between me and you now. Why are you going to put the Jew over me? Left and right. Now what do you leave so I can spray your house? So Ali bin Abi Talib, he says, I have my son al-Hasan. So the judge says, he says, Ya Ali, please man, do you have anything else? He says, no, Allah, that's all I have. He says, since that's all you have, and the only witness you can give me is your son, he says, then I have to rule in favor of the Jew. Stand for the haq even when it's against yourself, even when it's against your dad, even when it's against your amir, even when it's against a Muslim. Stand for the haq, because that's the quality of a believer. Call a spade, and don't call it a big spoon. If your brother's in the wrong, swallow the pill. I'm not saying you turn your back on your brother. I'm not saying that you let your son go. I'm not saying that you, no. But call it for what it is, and take a role for making the wrong right. That's what it takes to be a man. So I'm not saying that, you know, if my son did something, I'm not telling you to abandon your son and leave him. No, that's not what's being said. No, you stand by your son. Of course, that's your son. But you call it for what it is. If he's in the wrong, you tell him it's in the wrong. And you take a stance for the haq, and you try to make the wrong right. So the Jew, he doesn't know. He's thinking, what did I smoke this morning? Am I seeing this? That's Amir al-Mu'mineen. And he took me to a Muslim court in front of a Muslim judge, and he ruled in my favor. So it's a sahih hadith, you know, it's a sahih story. So the Jew bears witness. He says, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah, and he accepts Islam. But you know, for you and I, the most amazing part of the story is, wow, at the end the Jew accepted Islam. Habibi, that's not the amazing part. The amazing part is, even when the judge ruled against Ali bin Abi Talib, Ali bin Abi Talib didn't kick up a stink with the judge. The Jew, when he seen this, he accepted Islam, and he says, by Allah, this shield does belong to Ali bin Abi Talib. It was stolen from him, and yes, I was selling it in the